The Deathwatch are a unique chapter of Space Marines who aren't just drawn from one source, but instead they're drawn from the very best of alien killers from chapters across the length and breadth of the Imperium. And this, of course, gives them so much character and makes them tons of fun to collect. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint a veteran from a Deathwatch kill team. And this guy really is the standard of the Deathwatch army. So you can use the techniques I'm going to show you in this video to paint anything that you want to collect for your Deathwatch army. So go grab your paints and things, and we'll begin. Whenever you're painting Space Marines, it's almost always best to start out with their main armour colour, and in the case of the Deathwatch, that's going to be black. And the first stage of doing this, well, you might think it's a little bit strange, because the model has been undercoated with Chaos Black spray, but now what we're going to do is paint the entire thing using a Abaddon Black. Now, the reason for this is, and just in case really, later on if we make any mistakes and we have to neaten up, in which case we'll use Abaddon Black. Now, Abaddon Black and Chaos Black have a different finish, so if we skip this step, when we neaten things back up, you'll notice it and you'll get kind of like a patchy, blotchy effect. It doesn't look very nice, so it's a good idea to do this first. So, Abaddon Black is the colour, and as always, remember to give all your paints a good shake before you use each one. And because I'm going to be applying this basically all over the miniature, I'm going to go for a big brush for this. So I've got my large base brush. And what you need to do is just get some of this paint and put it onto a palette. Having a palette's always a good idea because it allows you to control exactly how much paint is on your brush. And also, it means you can thin it down with some water as well, which is important in this case because we want to avoid any brush marks appearing on the miniature. So you're looking to get to your paint to about that sort of consistency there. So it's a little bit transparent on your palette. And when you're ready, it's just a case of applying this all over the miniature where you want it to be black. Don't worry about getting it anywhere else at this stage because it doesn't really matter. We're going to start applying other base colours later on as we get to other details. But for this case, it's just a matter of getting a nice smooth coat all over the black armour. Once that Abaddon Black's completely dry, you're ready to start highlighting all the armour. And for this, I'm going to use the edge highlighting technique. And to do it, the colour you need is Eschen Grey. Now, to do this, basically what we're looking to do is to pick out, well, all the edges of the armour, hence the name of the technique. And to do it, you need a small layer brush, and you must use your palette here, because the key to it is to thin your paint down enough that it's flowing smoothly, but not so much that it's going to run everywhere and you lose control of it. So what you're looking to do is to thin it down to about a little bit thinner than that, I think. So just a small amount more water. There we are. We're looking for that sort of consistency there. And then what you do is just drag your brush along and twist it on your palette to bring the bristles to a nice tip. And when you're ready, it's just a case of picking out all those sharper edges. Now, I'll show you first of all in the helmets. It's a great example here, just beneath the eye. A good corner there, like a nice sharp corner on the armour. All we've got to do is basically follow along that detail with this colour to pick it out with a nice line like that. And same just above the eye there too. Now, sometimes these armour panels are very well defined, in which case what you can do is use actually the edge of your brush, like on here, for example, this vent, hold about 45 degrees and just run along it like that to get a nice straight line. But really, this is all down just to taking your time and being as neat as you can. And if you do make any mistakes, just neaten back up with Abaddon Black. I finished applying the highlight to the armour now, and you can see it's helping to bring those plates out. However, it is quite subtle, so if you want to, you can now add a second highlight. It is optional. If you want to do it, you need Fenrisian Grey, but be aware that when you're highlighting with this colour, it's important that you don't do it too much, because if you do, it can look quite garish. So just be very selective about it. Now, I'm going to use a smallish brush I've got, which is my extra small artificer layer, and I recommend you go for the smallest brush you have. And what you need to do is get your paint ready, as we did previously, by thinning it down with a little bit more water than normal, so it's flowing smoothly. And then you must make sure you get that good tip in your brush. So a bit thinner than that, I think. So there we are, looking for that sort of consistency. And then make sure I've got rid of the excess and got that good tip of my brush. And then it's just a case of picking out the very sharpest details of the armour. So for example, if we go back to the helmet, the sharpest part on the front here is going to be the brow, just above his nose, really. So I'm just going to add a very small amount of this colour onto there like that, just to bring that detail out. You see, I'm just being very gentle and very careful. And I'm not going over all the grey that we've done previously, but that just starts to make that detail pop out a little bit more. So all you need to do now is carry on doing this all across the armour. I've finished applying the Fenrisian Grey highlight, and you can see just what a difference it's made by giving us a lovely sharp finish to all of that armour. But remember, as you're doing this highlight, just be careful about how much you put on. If you do too much Fenrisian Grey, it looks very stark, so just be cautious about how you're applying it. And now we're going to move on to the next feature of the Death Watch, which is a very unique and distinctive feature of them, and that's their left arm, because not only is their chapter badge silver, but the whole arm is. So we're going to paint this to a lovely blue steel finish. Now, to do it, the first colour we need is Lead Belcher, and this I'm going to be applying mostly with my medium base brush, but it's a good idea to have a small base brush on hand for some more fine details, which you'll see in a moment. But what you need to do is thin your paint down on your palette with a bit of water, as we have been doing, so it's nice and smooth, And when you're ready, it's just a case of applying this to the entirety of the left arm and shoulder pad as well, just making sure you work it into all those little details as you go. Now, you don't have to worry about details you're not painted yet, like the power sword. It doesn't matter if you get some of this colour on those, but do be careful whenever you get close to that black that we finished so far. That's what your small base brush will be useful for, especially when you're getting close around the backpack, just around here. Now, you will also need to apply two thin coats to this as well, just to bring it up to a nice solid finish before you move on to the next stage. Once you've built up the lead belcher, the next thing to do is to shade all of this metal. And to do this, we're going to use non-oil, and I'm going to be applying it using my medium layer brush. Basically, the reason for this is because I don't want to put on too much at once, and this is a good side brush to control exactly how much I'm applying, you see. So you need to get some on the palette so you can judge exactly how much is on there. You want about so much. And when you're ready, all you got to do is start painting this directly over the silver. Now, as you do this, you just want to make sure it settles into all the recessed detail. So you can see us there, it's bringing out all that lettering really nicely. But also, just be careful not to get it onto any of the black armour that you've done so far. Now, the reason for this is because it will dry with a slightly different finish to a Baden black, and you don't want that to show up once it's finished. So just be neat around those areas. The shade is now completely dry, and you can see how it's given us loads of depth and all that detail, but it has mattered it down and darkened it down too. So what we need to do now is brighten it back up to get that shiny silver back. I'm going to use Iron Breaker to do this, and I'm going to be applying it still with my medium layer brush. And what I'm looking to do here is to paint it almost everywhere, but avoiding certain parts. So for that reason, you've got to make sure that, as usual, you thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth, but also make sure that you're not applying too much at once. So get the excess paint off your brush, get that nice tip there. And what you're looking to do here is to basically paint all of it, except avoiding the areas where the shade is settled the most. So for example, here on the shoulder pad, what I'm going to do is follow the flatter edge of the rim all the way around like that. And as I get close to where the skull is here for the Deathwatch badge, I'm just going to avoid those recesses where the shade is settled down there like that, you see? And same just on the skull there, like that. Now on the text, the best thing to do is to make sure you don't have much paint on your brush, and just very gently just run it across the text like that, so the bristles just catch the raised detail of the lettering, and pick those out easily and nicely for you there. With Iron Breaker applied, we've now once more got a nice bright silvery finish to the arm. And the next thing to do is to give it that blue steel tint. And to do this, we're going to glaze it using Gulliman Blue. I'm going to dilute it using Lamia Medium. Now, the reason for diluting it is because Gulliman Blue on its own will turn the arm blue. And we want to avoid that. It needs to be much more subtle. And we're using Lamia Medium to do this instead of water, because Lamia Medium basically allows me to dilute a paint without changing its properties. If I was to use water instead, what would happen is we'd get a very rough-looking finish, and I want it to be as smooth as possible. So Lamia Medium is perfect for that. I'm going to apply this using my medium layer brush, and what I'm looking to do is to create a mix of about half and half, but if in doubt, put more Lamia Medium in than Gulliman Blue. And when using Lamia Medium, it's very important, make sure you clean your brush whenever you get some out of the pot, because you don't want to contaminate it with any colour. And I'm looking for a roughly equal amount here. Just pop that on the palette and then mix them together. Now, like I said, if in doubt, put more Lamia Medium in than you've got blue. So you're looking for that sort of consistency though, and when you're ready, don't apply too much at once. All you've got to do is paint it onto the silver areas that we've got here. And you're looking to focus it really on the flatter areas. So you get a very subtle blue on those flat panels there like that. So it's not too strong, just gives a nice steely impression. The glaze is now completely dry and the effect is subtle, but that's perfect because that's exactly what we want. Now all we need to do is to highlight the silver, and to do this we're going to use Stormhost Silver. Now I'm going to be applying it with my small layer brush because I want to edge highlight this. So the technique is exactly the same as what we did for the Black Power Armour previously. Make sure your paint's thinned and that you've got a good tip on your brush. Thin it a little bit more than normal. So there we go. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is follow around all the sharper edges of this bit, of these parts of detail. So for the shoulder pad rim, for example, I'm just going to follow this edge along here like that, just picking out with a fine line of silver. And remember, sometimes what you can do is angle your brush at 45 degrees to catch those sharper edges, such as round there, like that. Now, when it comes to the lettering, all you've got to do is to make sure you don't have much paint on your brush, and just very lightly run it across the letters so that the brush just catches the raised details of them there, like that. And there we are, with the highlight applied, the silver arm is complete. Now the next detail we're going to paint is actually a very small one. It's going to be all the joints that are in the armour, and all these parts should already be black. So if you've got any other colours on them so far, just neaten them up with a Baden black before you do this next stage, because all we need to do is to highlight them using Skaven Blight Dinge. Now this is a different grade to what we used on the armour, because it will give us a subtly different effect for these parts, so it's ideal for this kind of purpose. And what we need is a small airbrush to apply it, and basically it's, as before, pop it onto your palette, thin it down with some water so it's flowing nice and easily. And when you're ready, all you're looking to do is to pick out the raised ridges of these joints. So I'm going to do this one here on the back of the leg. All you've got to do is just very gently paint some lines following the raised details of these parts. And with those joints painted, we're now going to move back on to painting some more metal, because now we're going to paint all the darker silver parts. So this is for all kind of the more mechanical bits, so things like the details on the bolt gun, vents, all that sort of thing. Now all these parts are going to be painted in the same way. I'm going to start out with a base coat of Lead Belcher, then we'll shade all over them with Nuln Oil, before finishing off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But starting out with our base colour of Lead Belcher, I'm going to be using my small base brush to apply this, but you might want to have a small brush on hand. A small airbrush is really useful for small details like the mouthpiece, for example. It's quite tricky to get to that on Mark 8 Power Armour. But what you need to do is get your paint ready on your palette, thin down with a bit of water, and then it's just a case of picking out these parts and applying this base colour. I'm going to start here in the bolt gun, and I am going to be applying two thin coats to build up to a nice strong finish before we move on to the shade. The next step is to shade all over the Lead Belcher using Nuln Oil. Now I'm using my medium layer brush for this because remember, you want to keep it under control and avoid getting it on any of the black armour that you've completed so far. Once the shade's completely dry, the next thing to do is to highlight all the metal using Stormhost Silver and your small layer brush. And all you need to do is just follow along all the sharper edges, picking them out with some fine lines. And with the highlight fully applied, the darker silver areas are now complete and we can start painting on the next colour. Now this is going to be all the red parts. So we're looking at the weapon casing here, but also the stripe that's on the knee that denotes what watch company a Space Marine is from. Now to do this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Corn Red, then we're going to shade the bolt gun using Nuln Oil before adding a highlight to all the red parts using Evilson Scarlet. But starting out with Corn Red for our base colour, I'm going to go from a small layer brush right from the start here because I now want lots of control as to where exactly I'm applying this. So as always, thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth in your palette, looking for about that sort of consistency, and make sure you've got that good tip on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this base colour to the areas that you want to be red. Now the weapons are all shown very clearly on the box, so you can see how each one has different red parts on them, but for all of them, you just need to apply a nice thin coat like this, and I am going to be applying a second coat as well to build up to a nice strong finish. As for the stripe on the knee, what I'm going to do here is a vertical stripe like we see on the box front, and the best way I find to do this is to start by keeping your hand steady and just painting a straight line down the centre of the knee pad there like that. And you can gradually work out either side just to make the stripe wider. I'm going to be doing two thin coats here as well, and if you do make any mistakes, just neaten up with a Baden Black. Once you've finished applying the Corn Red, the next thing to do is to shade over the bolt gun using Nuln Oil. Now remember, use a smaller brush for this, so I've got my medium layer brush, and what you're looking to do is just get all the details, all the recessed areas like that. But remember, you don't have to do this on the stripe, just the gun casing. Once the red's completely dry, all you need to do is to highlight the red, finish it off using Evilson Scarlet. You just need your small layer brush and to pick out all the sharper edges just with a fine line to give them a nice highlight to complete them. Now as for the knee pad where the stripe is, all you need to do is apply the highlight just on this small part along the top here and not down either side of it. Once you've finished highlighting those parts, all the red details are finished, and we can now start painting the next area, which is going to be all the gold parts. Now these details vary quite a lot depending on how exactly you built your Space Marines, but in all cases, I'm going to start out with the base colour of Retributor Armour. Now I'm going to be applying this with my small layer brush still, because these details, a lot of them are really small, so you want lots of control as you do this, and this brush is ideal for that kind of thing. So as always, make sure your paint's nice and smooth, thin down your palette, and make sure you're not applying too much at once. All you've got to do is, well, pick out all the parts that you want to be gold. I'm going to start here on the Chapter Badge, and all you got to do is just apply this being as neat as you can, and if it is a bit transparent, just apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way once the first coat is dry. I've applied two thin coats of Retributor Armour, and with that built up, we're now ready to move on to the next step, which is to shade all of the gold. And for this, I'm going to use Agrax Earthshade, applied with my small layer brush. Now, like I said before, as we get further and further on painting the miniature, we have to work around more and more details, and that's especially important here, especially when we're painting that chapter badge. So make sure you don't have too much of the shade on your brush, and just be careful as you apply it. Put it on in moderation so you don't lose control of it and get it onto the silver. Allow the shade to dry completely to give some definition to that recessed detail, but now what we need to do is brighten that gold back up again and give it that shine back. So to do that, we're going to do a layer of Auric Armour Gold. Now this I'm still going to be applying with my small layer brush, and what we're looking to do is, as always, use the palette, and we're basically looking to paint the flatter areas of these details and avoid the recessed parts where the shade still is. So make sure your paint's nice and thin, flowing easily, and you're not putting on too much at once. And when you're ready, what we're looking at doing is, well, on this skull we've got here on the shoulder plate, for example, I'm just going to very lightly start applying this to the flatter areas, such as up here on the forehead. We're just being very gentle so I avoid the recessed bits like the eye sockets where the shade has settled. So you just need to carry on doing this on all the gold. Once you've finished applying that layer of auric armor gold, you'll see that bright shine is back, and now all we need to do is to highlight the gold to finish it off. And for this, we're going to go back to Stormhost Silver, and I'm going to be applying it once again with my small layer brush. Now, what we're looking to do here is just pick out some of the sharper details just to give it a nice highlight, but be careful not to do too much of them because you can turn the gold silver then, and we want to keep it with that nice gold color. So make sure you don't have too much paint on your brush before you begin, and when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to pick out any sharper details or more prominent features on the gold. So for example, on our skull we've got here, I'm just going to add a small amount of this across the top of the forehead there like that, and around the eye sockets there as well, around the brow, just on top of the nose, just little details like that just to finish the color off. And once you've finished applying all those highlights, all the gold details are complete. And now the next thing we're going to do is scattered all over the model, quite small details. It's all the leather parts next. Now all these bits we're going to be painting in the same way. First of all with a base coat of Rhinox hide, then we'll shade all over them with Agrax Earthshade before finishing off with a highlight of Doomball Brown. Now I'm going to be beginning with my small base brush to do this, and as always just make sure you get the paint under control, because these details do vary quite a lot in size, so switch to a small brush if you need to. But basically all you've got to do is make sure you don't have too much paint on your brush at once. And when you're ready, all you got to do is work your way around the miniature, picking these parts out. And I'm going to start with these bits that we've got here on the chest plate, small bits of leather, just being really careful around details that I've already completed. With that base coat done, the next thing to do is apply some Agrax Earthshade over all the leather. And I'm still using my small layer brush so that I don't put on too much at once. Once the shade's completely dry, all you need to do to finish off the leather is to give it a highlight of Doomball Brown following all the sharper edges. Once you've finished applying that highlight, all the leather is complete. And now the next detail is going to be the Power Sword Blade, which we're going to paint in quite a similar way to how we did the silver arm on the Space Marine, only slightly different, so I guess a slight difference in the end once we finished it. We're going to start out with a base coat of Lead Belcher, and then we'll layer all over it using Iron Breaker to make that silver brighter. After that, we'll shade it with Norn Oil, and then we'll give it a glaze of Gulliman Blue, this time not diluted, so we get a nice strong blue on there. And then we'll finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But starting out with our base colour of Lead Belcher, I'm going to use my medium base brush here because we don't have to work around lots of intricate detail at this point, so a large brush like this is perfect. And once your paint is ready, all you need to do is get a good base coat on the sword. So I'm just going to start applying it along the length of the blade like this, and I will be applying two thin coats to build up to a nice strong finish. With the base coat done, the next thing to do is to layer all over the blade using Iron Breaker and your medium layer brush. With that done, the next step is to apply a shade of Norn Oil all over the blade. Now you want this to be as smooth as possible and a thin coat as well, so just keep an eye on it as you're applying it to make sure you don't get any pooling on the flat of the blade. Once the shade's completely dry, the next thing to do is to glaze all over the blade with undiluted Gulliman Blue. And finally, switch to your small layer brush to apply a highlight of Stormhost Silver following all the sharper edges on the blade. And once you've finished applying that highlight, the Power Sword Blade is complete, and now we can start moving on to the next detail, and this is going to be the Purity Seals. Now all of these we're going to paint in the same way, starting out by base coating the wax using Screamer Pink, and then the parchment using Rakarth Flesh. After that, we'll shade both these colours at the same time using Agrax Earthshade before we move on to highlighting. And we'll start with the wax, for which we're going to use Pink Horror. Then on the parchment, we'll start with Rakarth Flesh first of all, just to layer it, but then we'll highlight it using Pallid Witch Flesh. After this, if you want, you can add some text to the parchment, and if you do, you need Rhinox Hide for that. But starting out, first of all, with Screamer Pink for our base colour, I'm going to use my small base brush to apply this, and what we're looking to do is basically just, well, base coat that area, and these parts are quite small, so really make sure you got your paint under control before you do this. On my Space Marine, there's only one Purity Seal, and it's just here on the back of the bolt gun, so I'm just going to start by base coating this area, just being really neat and careful of all the other details. Next, we need to base coat the parchment, and for this you need Rakarth Flesh, and you will need to apply two thin coats. With both those base colours now applied, the next thing to do is add some Agrax Earthshade over both, and because I don't want to apply too much and lose control of it, I'm doing this with my medium layer brush. Allow the shade to dry completely, and then it's time to begin highlighting. First of all, using Pink Horror for the wax, and I'm using a small airbrush to apply this, and all I'm doing is just applying it very gently, so I'm only catching the raised details and leaving the recessed areas with the darker colour still showing. Now we're ready to begin highlighting the parchment, and the first thing to do this is to go back to Rakarth Flesh and apply this over most of it with your small layer brush, but this time just avoiding the deepest recesses where the shade has settled. So for example, we're looking at things like folds in it. So just there, you can see I'm just leaving that bit of recess shading showing still there, just to give it a bit of depth. And then to finish off the parchment, the next colour you need is Pallid Witch Flesh, and this we're going to apply as a highlight. So following all the sharper edges, so all the way around, but also whilst you're at it, look for any sharper creases and just paint a line following those as well. And finally, if you want to, you can add some script to the parchment using Rhinox Hide applied with your extra small artificial layer brush. And all you have to do is just paint some wiggly lines running across the parchment to simulate the text. I've finished applying the text now, and there we are, the purity seal is complete. And now the next detail is, well, it's going to be quite a small one now, because we're going to start painting all the lenses. So this is going to be for things like targeters and the eyes on the helmet, of course, and all of them are going to paint in the same way for a cool gem-like effect. Now to do it, the base colour we're going to use is corn red, and then we're going to shade over that with Norn oil. After that, we're going to begin highlighting, first of all, with Evil Sun Scarlet, then a small amount of Fire Dragon Bright, then an even smaller amount of Uriel Yellow before we finish off with a tiny amount of White Scar. But starting out with Corn Red for our base colour, I'm going to go straight for my extra small artificial layer brush right from the beginning here, because these details, well, are very small now. So make sure you've got your paint nice and thin so it's flowing smoothly, but be careful to make sure you don't overload your brush, especially when water's involved. You don't want it to all run everywhere. So looking for it to be about that kind of consistency there. And when you're ready, all you got to do is apply this base colour to all these areas. Now, for the eye lens here on the helmet, you don't actually have to paint all of it. You just want to paint the majority of the middle so that you've got a good solid base coat there like that, and with some of that black still showing around the edge. But as for these other lenses, just make sure you get the whole area, and you will need to apply two thin coats of this colour as well to build up to a nice strong finish. The next stage is to apply Norn oil over each of the lenses, and you really don't need very much of this, so I'm still using my extra small artificial layer brush. Once the shade's completely dry, it's time to start highlighting the lenses. First of all, with Evil Sun Scarlet, and on these rounder lenses, what you want to do is just paint a semicircle around the lower right, well, corner really, of each one. So just around that area there. But as for the actual eyes of the helmet, in this case, what you want is a line at the front, just running about halfway along the bottom of each one. The next colour to apply is Fire Dragon Bright in the same locations, but this time even less of this colour. The next colour to apply is Uriel Yellow, once again in the same areas, but this time we want just a tiny amount of this colour. And finally, to complete the gem effect, all you need to do is add a tiny dot of White Scar in the opposite corner to where we've been highlighting. Then there we go. And if you want, after that, you can add a coat of Ardco Gloss Varnish to give it a nice shiny look. But whether you do that, of course, is entirely up to you. And there we are, the lenses are complete, and now we just have one more feature left to paint on our space marine to finish it off. And it's quite a big one, because now we need to paint the chapter badge that's on the right shoulder pad. And this chapter badge marks out where exactly the space marines come from, so it's quite an important part of the Deathwatch list. Now the chapter you pick is of course entirely up to you, and we've got lots of painting videos on different chapters, so Ultramarines or Blood Angels or whatever you want to do. But for this example, we're going to paint an Imperial Fist, so we need to do this yellow. Now a great way of getting a nice bright yellow is first of all to paint the area with white. So the colour we're going to use is Ceramite White. Now this I'm going to be applying with my small base brush, and as we have been doing, you just need to first of all make sure you thin your paint down on your palette so it's nice and smooth. So I'm looking for about this sort of consistency here, there like that, and once you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting this on all the areas that we're going to be doing yellow. So I'm looking at this kind of area here, just being really careful whenever I get up to that trim of the shoulder pad, but not worrying about the chapter badge because we're going to paint that later. But for this badge, I do need to do the inside of this part white as well, because the inside of the roundel is going to remain white. Now, as you can see, the colour's a little bit transparent, so I will be applying a second thin coat in exactly the same way once the first one is dry. Once you've finished building up that white base coat, the next thing to do is to start adding the yellow to it. So for this, we're going to use Uriel Yellow, applied as a layer, using my medium layer brush. And what we're looking to do here is basically get a nice solid yellow, and this will take very quickly over that white. So for that reason, you'll only need to do one coat of it. But be sure that you've got your paint nice and thin, so you're going to get a nice smooth result to it. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying it. And remember, for this Imperial Fist badge, all you need to do is paint this on the outside. The inside of the roundel, you want to keep that part white. With both those colours established, we're now ready to move on to the next phase, which is to shade them both. And to do this, we're first of all going to shade the yellow parts using Reichlin Flesh Shade, and then the white parts using Norn Oil. Now, first of all, starting with Reichlin Flesh Shade, I'm going to be using my small layer brush to do this, and what I'm looking to do is to be very delicate about where exactly I apply this. Basically, I want to paint it into all the recessed areas. So for that reason, just make sure you don't have too much of the shade on your brush at once. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint this into any corners, really. So for example, where the yellow meets the black of the shoulder pad rim, I'm just going to run some of this shade into that area there like that, just to get a nice neat line there. Now if you do make any splodges, don't worry about it. Just let the shade dry and then neaten up with Uriel Yellow before you continue. I've finished applying that shade and I've neatened up as well, and now I'm going to do exactly the same thing using Norn Oil on the white parts. And as before, what you're looking to do is to paint this into the recessed areas as neatly as possible, but if you make any splodges, just neaten with Ceramite White once the shade is dry. Once you've finished applying those shades, you'll see that the chapter badge is now nicely defined, but it is a little bit messy, so what we need to do now is basically colour it in to sort that out. And what we're going to do is start out with a Baden Black to do this, and I'm going to be applying it using my small layer brush. And the thing to remember about this part is that, because we're working with black here, it's a very strong colour and all around some very light colours, so you must be careful as you're applying this, really take your time. So make sure your paint's nice and thin, you haven't got too much, and what you're looking to do is to basically paint this over all those messy parts. Now all the fine work's been done for us already with the Norn Oil earlier on, so really all you're doing is just colouring in these areas like this. With that done, all that remains to finish off the chapter badge is to highlight the black parts of it. So for this, I'm going to use Eschen Grey and basically do the same technique as what we did for highlighting the power armor right back at the start. So I'm using my small airbrush, and what I'm looking to do is to edge highlight the symbol just to give it a bit more definition. So once your paint is ready and you've got that good tip in your brush, all you're looking to do is to basically follow with fine lines all around the sharper details of this, this pattern. So just as neatly as you can. And once you've done this, well, all that remains to do is to base your miniature. And as always, I recommend you base it in the same way as the rest of your army. There we are. The Deathwatch Veteran is now fully based and ready to go forth and destroy the alien in the name of the God Emperor and the Ordo Xenos. Now remember, everything we've shown you in this video can be applied to any Deathwatch miniature that you want to paint. So whether it's Vanguard veterans or Terminators, bikers or even characters, all the techniques in this video can be used to paint those models. But the key things to remember are, when you're painting a miniature that's mostly black, be sure to paint it with a Baden Black first of all, even if you've undercoated it with Chaos Black Spray. Now the reason for this is because a Baden Black has a different finish to it than Chaos Black Spray. So when you need to neaten things up, if you haven't done this, you will notice a difference between the two blacks. Now on Space Marines, the real key part to painting them well is to do the power armor. So take your time with those highlights, because if you get it right, your miniature is going to look fantastic. And finally, further on in painting this miniature, we started to use shades in a very delicate way. So remember, just be careful not to put on too much, because even Norn Oil will show up on a Baden Black. And there you go. Now we hope you have loads of fun painting your Death Watch, and of course have success with them in battle as well. We'll see you again very soon with another tutorial. If you enjoyed that video and you'd like to see more, then why not subscribe to Warhammer TV? It's crammed with content, including loads of other tutorials. And in fact, if you'd like to watch another tutorial right now, why not click one of the links below?